Good morning, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. It is my great pleasure to give a keynote speech at this meaningful conference today. Let me first express my appreciation to Dr. Jungkyung Kim, President of the Korea Development Institute, and Dr. In-jae Lee, President of Korea Labor Institute, for organizing this conference in a short period of time. I would also like to convey my sincere gratitude to Secretary General of the OECD, Angel Gurriel, although he is not with us today. As the initiator of implementing job strategy for a long time, the OECD has been fully supportive of Korea government's efforts to raise employment rate. It is in this context that the OECD willingly co-organized today's conference and its prominent expert, Dr. Jean-Luc Schneider, Deputy Director of the Policy Studies Branch of Economics Department, has joined us today. We are most grateful. I would like also to thank all the speakers, discussants, and guests for being with us this conference. The new government puts its top priority on achieving 70% employment rate and unveiled a roadmap accordingly on June 4th to reach this goal within 5 years. The roadmap places enhancing employment rate at the center of economic policy and lays out ways to strengthen small and medium-sized enterprises and the service industry. Furthermore, it seeks to nourish quality part-time jobs by shortening working hours and expand the job market, especially for those with a relatively low participation in economic activities like women and youth. Aside from being the only one developed by the new government, the roadmap carries significance in 4 aspects. First, this roadmap marks a turning point in the government's economic policy focus. The government is placing more emphasis on employment than on growth. This does not mean growth is disregarded. As you may know, Korea achieved a remarkable economic growth in the 20th century, referred to as the miracle on the hard labor. The economy demonstrated strong economic growth, naturally leading to the job expansion, which made people better off. This reignited growth and eventually created a virtuous circle of stronger growth and job creation. At one point, however, job growth began to slow down, even though economic growth continued, giving rise to serious issues like economic disparity between the rich and the poor. Moreover, the stagnant economic growth for the past 8 quarters in a row has caused concerns that our economy may be threat in a low growth. More people now understand the importance of boosting employment as much as growth. This roadmap is a milestone that represents a transition to a new era where the Korean economy values employment over growth. Second, the roadmap represents a fundamental change in the growth strategy. These days, many countries are faced with weakened job creation capacity despite signs of economic growth and recovery. That's why we all understand the need for different growth strategies that would both ensure economic growth and spur job creation. Therefore, the Korean government has pledged to boost small and medium enterprises and the service industry, believing that they are in a better position to create jobs. Moreover, Korea's initiative to build a creative economy, one of the national priorities of the new government, is creating a supportive environment for startups and new jobs, and contributing to the development of venture startups and small and medium enterprises to expand employment. Third, it underlines the need to revolutionize the existing way of working and job creating system. Currently, the annual working hours of Korean workers are more than 2,100 hours, the second highest among OECD countries, consequently creating job, work and life imbalances and decreasing happiness. This is reflected in the OECD Better Life Index released in May. What is even worse is that Korea labor productivity is significantly below that of the OECD average. The roadmap ambitiously proclaims to reduce long working hours to at least 1,900 hours a year, similar to most OECD countries, which will be the starting point for our efforts to balance work and life. Last but not least, the roadmap is a meaningful preparation against the nation's low fertility and rapidly aging society. As you know, Korean population is aging faster than any other countries in the world. The economically active population is expected to decline from 2017, and Korea will start to face labor shortage in 2021. By 2030, the labor shortage will be as much as 2.8 million or 8.5% of the total labor population. The roadmap presents increased participation of women and youth in economic activities as a solution. One of the roadmap initiatives is the adoption of a dual system in which students are given the chance to build field experience before graduation, as in the case of advanced nations. This will help the youth to easily enter the job market. Another initiative is augmenting the consulting service, dubbed as public employment service, for women to ensure female employment expansion. The Korean government will make every effort to implement the roadmap. The all related ministries will work together in a fully cooperative manner. However, it is true that there are many obstacles hindering the path towards our goals. For the government to accomplish these goals, the economic paradigm needs to be shifted toward small and medium enterprises and service industry through small and medium enterprises and the service industry reinvigoration, and by dramatically increasing the number of startups and new jobs. The Korean government has a will, power, and capability, but still it needs to go the extra mile to rise to this different challenge. The government plans to reduce the second longest working hours among OECD members to 1,900 hours, but this is not an easy task either. Reaching a compromise between the labor and the management will be difficult as employers face increased labor costs while workers have to accept decreased income. It is also an open question as to whether the introduction of quality part-time work jobs, one of the core initiatives in the roadmap, will actually be able to serve as a key driver of employment growth. Part-time jobs are widely perceived to be non-permanent, paid poorly, and have little job security. In this regard, the government plans to inhibit discrimination against part-time workers, as in the case of Netherlands or Germany, and offer social insurance support. However, to do so, it needs continuous attention and precise management. I hope today's conference will address such concerns and questions and produce interesting ideas and comments. Also, I hope discussions on best practice and experience of OECD countries would present a workable solution for Korea as well as serve as an opportunity to review, refine, and complement the roadmap. While achieving a 70% employment rate is an admirable goal, it is not an easy one to achieve. However, we believe it is a possible goal to attain. We achieve the miracle on the Han River when no other country could do so. The Netherlands, Germany, and UK have set a good precedence of successfully boosting employment rate to 70% in a very short time. With good benchmarking, Korea will be able to achieve this goal, which will then serve as a starting point for rekindling the miracle on the Han River. I hope today's conference serves as the key to the door of our belief and confidence in a goal achievement. I look forward to your active participation and contribution. Thank you very much for your attention.